Good morning, dear students. Let us study particular integral when RHS is of the form e power ax into v, where v is a function of x. So let's prove the theorem. With usual notation, prove that 1 by f of d into e power x into v is equal to e power ax into 1 by f of d plus a into v, where v is the function of x. Now let's prove this. Proof. Let's consider x to be a function of small x. We already have studied successive differentiation. By successive differentiation, we'll find what is the derivative of e power ax into x. You know this is two functions, so we will be using product rule. What is a product rule? Differentiable of two functions is u into dv by dx plus v into du by dx. So d into e power ax into x will be equal to e power ax into derivative of x plus x into derivative of e power ax gives us a into e power ax. Now from the first two terms, you know x is common and e power ax is also common. So when I take e power ax into x common, I'll be getting it as e power ax into d plus a into x. This is the first derivative. Now let us differentiate this again with respect to x. So it is d square into e power ax into x. This is nothing but derivative of the previous step. This is again product of two functions, where first function is e power ax, second function is d plus a into x. Now again let us use the product rule. So it is e power ax into derivative of d plus a into x plus d plus a into x as it is into differential of e power ax is a into e power ax. Now let me multiply the terms which is there in the bracket. First of all, let's take e power ax into x common. When I take e power ax into x common, the remaining terms are d into d is d square plus d into a is da plus, now again in the second term, da plus a square. So now this is of the form a square plus 2ab plus b square, which is nothing but a plus b whole square. So d square of e power ax into x is equal to e power ax into d plus a whole square into x. Now what we observe from this is, when we have the first derivative here, it is d plus a to the power of 1. When it is twice the derivative, it is whole square. Now similarly, d cube of e power ax into x will be equal to e power ax into d plus a whole cube into x. Now if I generalize it for nth term, d power n into e power ax into x will be equal to e power ax into d plus a whole power n into x. Now next what we will do is, we will be writing this as f of d. Instead of writing d power n, I'm going to write it as function of d. So f of d into e power ax into x can be written as e power ax into f of d plus a into x. Then the next step is, I will put f of d plus a into x, which is there on the RHS, is equal to v, where v is a function of x. Now from this, what is x equal to? X is equal to 1 by f of d plus a into v. Now I will be considering the previous step. I have f of d into e power ax into x is equal to e power ax into f of d plus a into x. Now in this, wherever I have x, I'll be substituting it as 1 by f of d plus a into v. Now when we substitute that, we get the next step. Now from this, first I'll write the RHS, then I'll be writing the left hand side. After this, what we are going to do is, I will be operating 1 by f of d on both the sides. So when I operate 1 by f of d on both the sides, left hand side becomes 1 by f of d is equal to e power ax into v, that's equal to 1 by f of d and f of d will get cancelled. I'll be getting it as e power ax into 1 by f of d plus a into v. This is the formula to find when it is a function of exponential and a function of v. Now let us consider the problems.